instrument digital interface, and as the name suggests, it was first created to produce music in the digital world. True to the nature of VJing and audiovisual performance, video artists have reappropriated that language to include video controls. So all the units you see right now are originally designed to trigger musical notes and fluctuate volumes and produce audio effects. But now, most VJ software incorporate MIDI control to do the same with video. MIDI incorporates two main parameters, either notes or volume. So volumes are either on or off, so 0 or 1, and volume ranges between 0 and 127. So all these numbers come from the MIDI controller into your computer and interact with software in different ways that you set up yourself, or you can interact, you can plug into a V4 with a V-Link and control a mixer that way too. MIDI controllers come in a variety of forms. They mainly emulate a musical instrument. So you have MIDI keyboards, drum pads, portable mixing stations, DJ emulators which copy the layout of a DJ mixer, and more funky versions that were custom built for specific uses by video artists. A lot of later models try to combine the features of musical instruments to have a more comprehensive interaction with the software. So here you have keyboards as well as drum pads and sliders to have a lot more control over the software. Later models also incorporate a USB connection which feed in and out the MIDI and also powers the unit. So you don't need to have an extra plug and to carry around. So you don't need to have an extra plug to carry around to make this unit work. So you'll notice on this specific unit, I've marked directly on the keyboard and the drum pads some notes for me to remind myself of what is going on into the software and what are the interactions I'm doing. And this is because the MIDI controller is where the performance really lies. This is what I'm using as a performance tool. This is what the audience is looking at when I'm doing my performance. This is where this is happening. And this is very different to just sitting behind a laptop. So the laptop can be on the side, hidden away, and the audience may only see that. So this is where I need to be looking at. So the more markings I have on my unit, the longer time I'm looking at this and not the computer. So these are the latest models, but I think it's nice to go for the old school simple one sometimes. This still has a full-size MIDI socket and you still need an electrical plug to make these work, but it's nice and simple layout, so these are all just knobs and you customize your software accordingly and it just fits almost in the pocket.
This is the Numark New VJ. You can see from the layout it very much resembles a DJ emulator. So if you are a DJ, you're starting out with AV performance, maybe this is the one for you. It's quite simple. You've got a USB connection in the back. You connect to the laptop. The USB also works as a power source, so you don't need to have another bits of cable to make it work. Just turn on the software. Software recognizes instantly the hardware, and the mapping also is instantly recognized, so the buttons are already assigned to a specific function on the software. So that is already done, and you're up and running in no time. So a good entry level controller. If you are a DJ, you want to get into AV performance, this is easy to understand. If you know about DJ mixers, then you pretty much know what these sliders do and the knobs. So this is something that you would pretty much be able to use after a couple of hours of playing around with it. This is a Korg microcontroller. It's very comprehensive in terms of how many keyboard and sliders and keypads it contains. So the more options you have, the more you can input into the software you're using, and that's coming very handy. Also the size of it, I quite like, because you have a nano control, which is fine, but this is a bit bigger, so it's just something that you don't need to look for. You know, it's not too small that, you know, it's finger size. It's not a full size keyboard still. You have much bigger things, so it's a nice compromise between something that's too big and too little, basically. So yes, now at the moment I've got it set up with triggering AV samples on the keyboard. So each key is a different sample, and the opacity is changed with this slider and the speed with this one. So each layer has a slider for opacity, and on top we have the corresponding speed levels. So I have four levels and four speed controls. Here some effects that are triggered, some effects that need parameters between 1 and 27, this would be here, and I've got all other effects that are more on and off, and they would be in the drum pad. Also on the ones below, the effects are on top, and at the bottom here I've got, if I need to highlight a specific layer, I've got these 8 pads here that I can do that with. This is the M-Audio trigger finger. It's a MIDI controller I use a lot for video DJing, and so I've again written out on top of the drum pads all the functions that I need to look at. So again, I don't need to look at the software so often. I know what I'm doing just from looking at what is on the unit. So I've got my cues. I can stop this. I've got my cues. I can change the PFL from each side of the virtual DJ set. On this side, I can change the beats, the in and out points. So if I want to do like this, I have a very quick loop and come out of it. I guess again even quicker, and then I can change the speed this way. Things like that come out, and here I am, and I can just change into the other side. Oh, it's finished. So let me just get it up again. Okay, where's my other? Oh, it's here. There we go. Okay, and I've got some speed settings and other features. So I've got all I need in terms of what I need as a DJ, as a visual DJ mix. It's not the same interface I would find on a DJ emulator, MIDI controller. You would have, you know, these two side things. But for me, because I'm using video at the same time, I need something else, and I need something that has more features laid out in a different way, and this works for me. So another thing I really like about this unit is that if you turn it around, you see there's a socket to put it on a stand, and all of a sudden you've got something that's not on the table anymore, and then you're playing it like a real instrument that's laid out with other things that are not necessarily like a DJ table. So again, it's much more of an instrument-like feel.